Hello, everyone. Thanks for joining. Welcome to the session on best practices when migrating from Amazon ECS with Amazon EC2 to AWS Fargate. My name is Juyong Kim, and I'm a container specialist solutions architect at Amazon Web Services. Before we talk about the migration, let's do a quick recap of Amazon ECS and AWS Fargate. ECS is a fully managed container orchestrator and helps easily deployable, manageable, and scalable for your applications that are containerized. Since this is managed by AWS, you don't have to consider about control planes upgrade, patching, and etc. AWS Fargate is a serverless environment for containers, also fully managed one. Once your ECS cluster prepared, Fargate offers option when deciding on the computing resources for hosting your ECS tasks. Just for your information, ECS task is basically a collection of one or more containers. So usually one, but sometimes more than one in case of sidecars. ECS and Fargate really combined well to give you a fully managed experience where you don't have to worry about all the heavy lifting of doing like patching and maintaining your AMI, your clusters, and things like that. So it's really saving you a big deal on operational overhead. In ECS, you can choose either container instance, which means EC2 instance, or Fargate for your ECS task. But also, you can get the flexibility to utilize a mix of both within a single ECS cluster. So when you choose Fargate to ECS cluster's computing engine, not only you can take advantage of that from a patching perspective, like around the ECS agent, but it also heavily related to security things as well. When you're looking at Amazon ECS with EC2, you're basically responsible for this middle layer here around the hardening operating system. Also, monitoring of this operating system and patching it where you run those containers. This is where the container runtime sits, and this is where the ECS agent sits, and any other agent that you may have running as kind of like daemon services or on those EC2 instances. These are something that you would have to manage and maintain. For Fargate, we take all of that and move it to our side of the fence for responsibility. So we will do the hardening, monitoring, patching, and also we will take care of the ECS agent from version perspective. And this means we take care for underlying components security. We just delved into Fargate's advantages in terms of management and security. With Fargate, AWS takes on the management for any underlying infrastructure which is below the container layer. And its dedicated resources per ECS task enhances the security by default. Then there is one additional thing I would like to tell you is that with Fargate, customers only get charged for tasks that they run, which means assigning resources per ECS task, and this can increase resource utilization compared to EC2 and lead to cost savings. Also, you can explore wide cost options like saving plans, Graviton, and Spot Fargate. And When looking at some of the releases that we did in the past 12 months, the first one being AWS Compute Optimizer. Compute Optimizer is a great tool, especially if you're very interested in looking at your cost and making sure that you're only right-sizing and using what you need. So, Compute Optimizer gives you a predictable view of how much you're spending on your ECS Fargate. You can see each of your tasks and your services and see what is the consumption that you're making there. And also, you can figure out how can you either downsize or increase resource amount. And this is something to really have that right sizing in mind. And it gives you predictions also. You can really drill down into past months and how you have been leveraging your containers. Then second thing, we have increased Fargate configuration up to 16 virtual CPU. That is something that our customers have been asking for a long time. And it helps with workloads like batch workloads, extracting, transforming, and loading jobs. And third thing, we increased our task launch rate improvement with the past 2 years. It had been a top request with Fargate. You know, we got customers who want it to be even faster what they are leveraging. And that is the feature we've released where now you will notice the difference of speed in Fargate. First one, service quota transition. This is something that done automatically if you were already using containers on ECS and Fargate. And migrated from the number of tasks to number of virtual CPU. And last but least, Fargate adds support for monitoring the storage utilization. So now you will be able to use things like CloudWatch Container Insight to do a deeper monitoring of your task ephemeral storage. Beyond that, we are working on another features driven by customers' need. So stay tuned. All right, we have briefly covered Fargate, and now let's cut to the chase. So what do we need to be aware of before moving to the Fargate? First, let's figure it out from the computing perspective. A single Fargate corresponds to a single ECS task, whereas you can place multiple tasks in EC2 instance up to the upper bound, which is allowed by EC2's capacity. Therefore, it is mandatory to define the task CPU and memory with the predetermined SKUs for AWS Fargate. Currently, with Fargate's capacity allowing up to 16 virtual CPU and 120 gigabytes for memory, the chances of not being able to use Fargate tasks due to a lack of SKU options are extremely slim. But when we are confronted with the question like, how do I determine the right size for each ECS Fargate? The first answer to this would be to use Compute Optimizer. Compute Optimizer continuously monitors your ECS services and uses a historical resource utilization metric to generate recommendations. So its recommendation helps you identify right size for ECS tasks, CPU, and memory. And the other answer would be getting insight with custom Fargate right sizing dashboard. With this dashboard, you can observe all Fargate tasks listed in your ECS cluster. And you can get each configurations and consumptions details with CPU and memory information as well. By tracking each Fargate metric, you can find a room for improvement regarding right sizing. Second thing that I have to consider is that we are still working on it, but Fargate doesn't support GPUs at this moment. Therefore, if your workload running on the top of ECS requires GPU resources, then it is not possible to migrate the ECS services to the Fargate. And then container image pull time might take longer than cached one. In ECS EC2, you can cache your container image locally by setting the ECS agent parameter. Whereas in Fargate, due to the immediate provisioning upon request, you cannot use caching feature. But we can still speed up and shortening provisioning time by optimizing container image size as light as possible, or compressing image size by using zzip or zstandard compression algorithm. Also, you can leverage a secable OCI, also known as Sochi. I didn't mention this in previous notable releases slide, but on July 17th, we just rolled out a new feature leveraging secable OCI to accelerate the provisioning speed of ECS Fargate. This is open sourced by AWS and enables the containers to start without waiting for the entire container image to be downloaded. This enables applications to scale out quickly and reduces the rolling out time for application updates. And the larger the container image size, the more effective it can be. And last thing in ULimit settings, which stands for user limit and control the resources available to a user process, you can only override nofile's default resource limit values. Other ULimit values such as memlock, data, etc., Fargate uses the default resource limit, which is not configurable. So, looking at it from a network standpoint, the default network mode for ECS EC2 is bridge. But in Fargate, AWS VPC mode is the only one option. What that means is that if you're not using AWS VPC mode in ECS to EC2, it also have to consider during migration process. And with this mode, you actually get a dedicated network interface per ECS task. There is pros and cons to this. The cons that you can lock down the security group to only the port that is required for that container. Also, you can track traffic flow by using VPC flow logs. You can easily say that this network mode gives ECS task the same networking properties as EC2 instance. But cons would be I needed an IP address for every single Fargate task that spins up inside my VPC. So it is crucial to allocate enough room during designing your VPC and subnet. And yeah, don't skimp on subnet size. If auto-scaling is in progress, concerns about IP depletion might arise. Second thing is that for the larger IP address space, IPv6 is supported, but only in dual stack mode. And that means each task gets both IPv4 and IPv6 address. In storage perspective, Fargate supports Amazon EFS, which is managed file system service, and ephemeral storage. But other external storage like EVS volume is not supported. Therefore, in the scenario where you are currently binding EVS volumes to your ECS workloads, it becomes imperative to seek out alternative substitutes. So when it comes to security, what considerations should be on our radar? I told you that in Fargate, we take on the management for any underlying infrastructure which is below the container layer. And this means we take care for underlying component security. Looking at it from a different standpoint, customers have limited flexibility in customizing these underlying components. Therefore, some features are not supported in Fargate. First of all, Fargate does not support privileged mode. Privileged mode is something that a container has the capability to access and manipulate all resources on the host system, and it can directly access kernel resources. Since this area is managed by us, this mode is not supported in AWS Fargate. Second thing is that CSP trace kernel capabilities is the only supported one in Linux capability. This allows observability tools like sysdig or Falco for detecting threats in container environments. And there is no runtime access for users like using SSH, but we prefer ECS execution rather than that. This is a kind of Docker execution or kubectl execution experience directly into the task. This is good when you want to do troubleshooting or debugging specific container. But obviously, you're not going to have any access to that underlying micro virtual machine there. For the last, just for your information, in ECS, there are two IAM roles, which are task execution IAM role and task IAM role. Task execution role is for the ECS agent and usually add IAM policy, something like pulling ECR images and sending CloudWatch logs. And task role is for the each task to access specific AWS services. For instance, if your ECS task read or put object into its S3, then corresponding policy is required. At Fargate, each task has its own ECS agent and task entity, so each IAM roles are able to have independent permissions. The other thing in perspective of deployment type, Fargate doesn't support a daemon scheduling strategy, which deploys exactly one task on each active container instance. My observations when helping customers, and they configure containers in daemon strategy, which has an agent-like nature, such as log router. By the way, in Fargate, there is not container instance layer, and each ECS task will be hosted on each Fargate, so you have to move daemon task to each task's sidecar. Here is another additional consideration when it comes to shift to AWS Fargate. Some of the task definition parameters, which is for ECS task or is for containers in task, aren't supported in Fargate. One example is that task placement strategies and constraints are not supported for tasks using the Fargate launch type. By default, Fargate tasks are spread across availability zones. Therefore, configuring the value for placement constraint is not supported. Also, please check other parameter list in our official document. Then for tasks on Fargate, the supported log routers are AWS Logs, Splunk, and AWS Firelands. If you're using other log driver outside of this scope, such as a syslog, it will be necessary to be changed into one of three. And last but least, you can easily configure Fargate spot capability with capacity providers. Fargate spot automatically manages the placement of spot instance across multiple availability zones, so no additional configuration is needed. I made a Fargate test definition validator tool for checking whether to migrate immediately or not in a wheel kick. As you can see in here, this is a simple tool automatically check ECS test definition if it is compatible with the AWS Fargate. Just to store your test definition JS file into the same place where you utilize this tool. At very first, cloning the repository and install required dependencies. And in here, I already prepared sample ECS test definition in examples folder. Open the JSON file, like which name is my nginx test JSON. And let's look around. And this is very simple example file with official nginx container image. Scroll down and you can see we didn't use any ECS task parameter, which is not supported in Fargate. Also, in log configuration, since this log driver values is AWS logs, and this is also supported one. Checking the network mode, AWS VPC is written in here. So I would say there is not concerns in this task definition file. So let's really see if that is the case. Click the terminator and then type the command fargate validator and specify file's location, like examples and my nginx test definition. And you can see as a result, everything seems okay. So you can take it right away. Then let's try another example, which name is fail task JSON. And it seems like there is GPU resources, and also you can see other configurations. And bottom of the line, in terms of network mode, it is currently using bridge mode, which is not supported in AWS Fargate. So open the terminal again. And then type the command the same before and specify file location, like Fargate validator and examples on fail task JSON. As you can see in here, as a validation result, you can see a lot of things have failed in this task definition file. And also you can see the reason why this is failed, and you can also check out each recommendation. This is all I have to share today. Please keep in mind key consideration when it comes to migrate your ECS test to Fargate in various perspectives like compute, network, storage, and etc. And please use Fargate validator before migrating your ECS service to AWS Fargate. If you have any questions or feedback, drop me a line. Thanks to watch AWS Online Tech Talk with migrating Amazon ECS EC2 to AWS Fargate.